is Allison Gonzalez. I'm a Microsoft Certified Trainer, and in this series, I am showing you all of the basics that you need to get started in Power BI. In this episode, we are going to get started with getting started. What do you do when you open up Power BI? What do all the buttons mean? And what do you click to get a project moving? So let's head on over to the Power BI desktop, and we are going to take a look at the interface and see what all of these buttons are about. Before we get to the video, I just want to let you know, if you are interested in more in-depth Power BI training, head on over to prag.org/allison40, and that's going to give you 40% off an annual subscription to our on-demand learning platform, where you have access to hundreds of different classes. Now, on to the video. Now, if you do not have the Power BI desktop downloaded on your computer yet, I will have the link below. That way you are able to click that and go directly to this page to be able to download the Power BI desktop. Now, if you are on a work computer, you may need to get permission. You may need to have it downloaded by someone in your IT department, right? You may need to request that, or you may have a specific location to download it. But if you have the ability to download, you can go right to this page, or you can go to the Microsoft Store on your computer to download it. Now, one thing that is very important to keep in mind with the Power BI desktop is that you can only currently run it on a computer that is also running Windows. So if your computer naturally runs Windows, fantastic. You can download the Power BI desktop completely for free. If you are on a Mac, you would need to be running another program that allows you to run Windows to then be able to download the Power BI desktop. Once you have downloaded the Power BI desktop, you are able to go ahead, open that up. Now you can of course open this up by going down to your taskbar and going to that search bar and just searching for the Power BI desktop. When you click on that link, it is gonna pull you up to this view right here. And this is called the Power BI home view. This is everyone's default view now when the program opens up. Now from this home view, you have a few options. First off, I can open up anything that I have previously worked on. If you've previously worked in Power BI, you can see all those different items right here, or easily search by clicking on the Open an Existing Report button over in that top left. But if we are just getting started here, we're gonna get started with a blank report. Now we see some other buttons here, and what that is showing us is that we can start right off the bat by connecting to our data source. So what I want you to think about is, if you're using Power BI, it is a data visualization program, what data do you want to visualize and where is that data located? So it may be in an Excel workbook, maybe it is in a SQL server, maybe from other sources. Right off the bat, I could connect from one of these. But what we're gonna do for today, we are just gonna start with a blank report. We are gonna take a look at the actual Power BI desktop without any data inside. So when you click on the blank report button, your screen will load and it will look very similar to this. There are some customizations you're able to make that I'll show you that may differ it slightly. But for the most part, you will have all of these same options that I have on my screen. Let's take a little tour around and talk about the different sections in the Power BI desktop and along with which sections you would use for different things. Now, first off, I see up at the top here, I have a variety of ribbons. Now, what I like to tell people when they are starting with Power BI is to think of the other Microsoft programs that they use on a regular basis, whether that is PowerPoint, Word, Excel, right? All of those have the same ribbon structure. So when Microsoft created the program, they didn't want to reinvent the wheel. They took the existing structure of those other programs and have it the same here. So I can see at the top, I have a home ribbon, an insert ribbon, a modeling ribbon, a view ribbon, an optimize, and a help. Now you may or may not have external tools, and that just depends on if you have other programs downloaded that would sync with the Power BI desktop. You may not have any, or you might have more than I do, and that is totally okay. And that again is dependent on your system. So if you do not see the external tools ribbon, or if you do not have Deck Studio, that is okay.
back over to our home ribbon, let's talk a little bit more about the structure that we see here. Now, off to the left side of your page, you have four different buttons. Everything, these four over here, are called views. So my first view is my report view, and this is where we are at currently. This is where you will build your report. The next one is my table view. We don't have any data in here yet, but when I do, this view will remind you of Excel. I will see columns and I will see rows of data, and I am able to, in my data pane, which is on the right side of my screen, everything on the right side of your screen are called panes, like a window pane. I can click through if I have multiple tables of data to see each one displayed in the space. The next view is my modeling view. Now in my modeling view, you will use this if you are bringing in different sets of data. Maybe you have two different Excel sheets. Maybe you're pulling data from a server, then you also have an Excel sheet, right? You can mix it up, whatever you need. If you are bringing in multiple sets of data, you need to be able to connect those data sets together by building a relationship on some common data. So that way your data is able to work simultaneously together in your visuals. So that way, if I have, let's say, data from a date table, as well as data from a sales table, I could use both of those elements together in one visual and it would work together. But to do that, I would have to come here to this modeling view to build connections. We'll talk more about that in another session. The last view that I have, again, remember your views are on the left, is called the DAX query view. Now the DAX query view is pretty new. This is one that came out in the past few months. And with the DAX query view, this allows you to understand more about your data, to really dig into your data and to do some really cool things with it. Now, most people, when they are starting in Power BI, will not be going anywhere near this DAX query view. Generally, it's a little bit higher level of a skill to be using this, but I did want to show you what it is, show you that you can click through to that view over on the left, but we are not going to be talking about it in this series. Now back up to my report view. Let's take a tour around of what our options are here in this report view. Now, first off, I always call everything that is to the left of the home button kind of Microsoft's place of honor. Whatever is placed here is what you know Microsoft really wants you to focus on and that you're going to be clicking on frequently. So we can see right here, the very first button I can click on is called the Get Data button. Now, the Get Data button is where you are able to connect to your data wherever that data lives, right? So thinking through, right, this is a data visualization program. What data do I want to visualize? So is that Excel spreadsheets coming from different servers? You are able to connect to it right from here. Now this is a two-part button. It's very slight, but you can see if you hover over the top part, the icon, that is going to pull up one menu, whereas if you hover over the bottom, that shows you common data sources. So we can see these are the ones that are chosen most frequently, and so we have an easy quick view menu for those. Now if you see that your data source is not located here, you can either click more, that is at the bottom of that list, or you can click on that top icon. Both of those will pull up the main menu that has all of the what are called connectors that allow you to connect to your data wherever that may be. And we have a variety of sources, hundreds of them. And you can also search in your search bar or specifically look through the left side to get what you need. You will also notice in this data section that we have Excel here. We also have Excel at the middle of our page. And of course, in that Get Data dropdown, there is also Excel. This is the same button. It does the exact same thing. It's gonna be the first time I say this in the series, but Microsoft loves to give you options. So they will show you the same exact button in multiple places and you can just pick the one that works best for you. So I could click, if my data was coming from Excel, I could click on this button up here, this one in my drop-down nav, or this one in the center of my page, and it would bring up the connector for my Excel data. Next up in my home ribbon, I also have a transform data button. Now, transform data launches the Power Query Editor. The Power Query Editor came from Excel. It's also still there in Excel. And I have a whole series here on our channel about doing edits in the Power Query Editor, which I will also link below. Now, this launches the Power Query Editor. So it will take your data and you can clean it up. And by clean it up, that just means you can remove the things that you do not need and add in any data that's not currently present that you would also like to have. Moving on, you may see a visual section and you are able to control this. This is part of your on object settings, which you will see in your preview features. And that allows you to have your visuals nicely sorted among some other updates that we talk about. You can also have, you know, some quick inserts. We have our whole insert ribbon with more options, but some popular things are right here. Later on, when we have data, we will be able to do calculations on that data. And then we finally have our publish button, because the Power BI desktop is really just for you. This is where you are able to look at your data, work with it. But if you want to share or collaborate, you need to publish it to what's called the Power BI service, which is powerbi.com. And while the Power BI desktop is free, the Power BI service does require a subscription. We then have our panes. Remember that window pane over to the right. And here I again also have all of the visuals that I can use, and I can sort through my different panes, like my data pane, the build pane, which has my visuals, my formatting options, and more are located here. Now you are able to control a lot of your behavior by going into your preview features, by going to File, Options and Settings, Options. And then halfway down this window, you can go into your preview features and you can make some changes like adding in your on object interaction, which is what I have on, to get the latest and greatest. Here in preview features, Microsoft is showing you, hey, these are the things that are coming soon, and you get to try them out in your Power BI before they are officially launched. This is our first episode in our Power BI series, opening up the program, taking a look around at that, and seeing the different buttons that we have access to, and how we can start off a project by clicking on that Get Data button. We're going to be diving more into getting started with Power BI in the next few episodes of our series. So make sure you are subscribing to the channel. That way you will get notified as soon as they are available.